Welcome to EPT Pathshala. Dear students, today's module is on solar collector. As we all know, sun is a continuous fusion reactor and the energy inside the sun is produced by the nuclear fusion process. And the energy from the sun reaches the earth. And the heat from the sun's rays can be harnessed for a variety of applications. It can be used for electrical or heat energy production. The solar thermal technology, especially deal with the collector, are used. These collectors are used for the heating purposes. And the photovoltaic panels can use to power the electrical device. The solar heat can be used as hot water production, air or steam production that can be readily deployed for meeting a number of applications in various sectors such as industries for the heating purpose, power generation on a large scale, even for community cooking and for the space cooling or heating. But these sun's rays are too diffuse to be used directly. So we need solar concentrators, which are needed to collect and concentrate sun's rays to heat up the working fluid to the required temperature. And the solar thermal technologies use various collectors to generate this heat. So in this module, we are going to learn about what are the types of solar collector, the optical efficiency of the solar collector, how to differentiate between the concentrated and non-concentrated collectors, and to know about different solar thermal technologies. Let's start with the components of solar thermal technology. The major one is the solar collector. This is the main component of a solar thermal system. It converts energy efficiently. The other one is the medium for the energy transport. It can be water, air, or other medium. The storage system to meet the energy available and the demand. And there should be systems to transport and use the energy or the medium. And also we need control systems. And if you see the principle of solar thermal technology, it is the conversion of solar energy into heat energy by absorbing it. And the solar collector works on the greenhouse effect principle. The solar radiation, which is incident upon the transparent surface of the solar collector, is transmitted through this surface. Solar collector. It is the device to collect and absorb solar radiation and to transfer the absorbed heat energy to the fluid, either air or water, in contact or passing through it. William H. Goethals patented the first solar thermal collector designed for the building roofs, and he called it as solar heat collector and radiator for the building roof. What are the features of a solar collector? The collector efficiency. It is denoted by eta, which is the ratio of energy actually absorbed by the collector to the energy incident on the collector. The absorbed energy by a collector is the solar energy which is transferred to the transport fluid as heat energy. Eta is equal to energy absorbed divided by the solar heat energy which is incident. The next feature is the concentration ratio. It is the ratio of the area of aperture of the collector system to the area of the receiver. The radiation is incident on an aperture area. You can see in this figure, the radiation is incident on an aperture area AA, which is then concentrating on a smaller area on the receiver or the absorber plate, which is given by AR. Then the concentration ratio CR is equal to AA by AR. And the third feature is the temperature range. It is the range of temperature to which the heat transporting fluid is heated up by the collector. The temperature depends upon this concentration ratio. The flat plate collector has concentration ratio of 1. As there is no focusing or optical concentration system is utilized in them to concentrate the solar radiation. And so the temperature range of flat collector is less than 100 degrees Celsius. The line focus collectors have concentration ratio up to 100, and these collectors have temperature range of 150 to 300 degrees Celsius. The point focus collector have very high concentration ratio with CR greater than 1000, and these collectors have a temperature range of 500 to 1000 degrees Celsius. Let's see an example. In a collector, the aperture area is 2 meters square, while it has an absorber area of 100 centimeters square. What will be the concentration ratio? We have seen that concentration ratio is equal to the aperture area divided by the absorber area. So ACR is equal to AA by AR, while AA is equal to 2 meter square and AR is equal to 100 centimeter square. If you convert that first to the meter square, and then CR is equal to 2 by 100 multiplied by 10 to 100 raised to minus 2. And we will get an answer of 200. That is the concentration ratio of that collector. And another example, a parabolic collector of length 2 meter has angle of acceptance as 15 degree. What will be the concentration ratio of the collector? Here, the concentration ratio is equal to 1 by sine phi max. But 2 phi max is equal to angle of acceptance, which is equal to, which is given as 15 degree. So phi max is equal to 15 by 2, that is 7.5. So the angle of acceptance is 15 degree and phi max is equal to 7.5. And here the CR is equal to 1 by sine phi max, that is equal to 1 by sine 7.5 equals 7.66. Now, we will learn how to classify this solar collector. Solar collectors are classified as low, medium or high temperature collectors based on the temperature requirements. Based on the temperature range, you can see in this table, the low temperature collector has a temperature less than 150 degrees Celsius, medium temperature collector has temperature range of 150 to 400 degrees Celsius, and high temperature collectors have more than 400 degrees Celsius temperature range. The low temperature collectors are used for the smaller non-intensive requirements, while medium temperature collectors are used for heating water or air for industrial and commercial use. High temperature collectors concentrate sunlight using mirrors or lenses and are used for fulfilling heating requirements up to 400 degrees Celsius, which is used in the industries. Now, what are the types of solar collector based on the heat requirement? Based on the heat requirement, the solar collectors are either non-concentrating or the concentrating. This is the most common type of classification of solar collector, non-concentrating type and concentrating type. In the non-concentrating type, the collector area, that is the area that intercepts the solar radiation, is the same as the absorber area. Absorber area is that area which absorbs the radiation. In this non-concentrating type solar collector, the all solar panel absorbs the light, while the concentrating collectors have a larger interceptor than the absorber. These non-concentrating solar thermal collectors are generally used for low and medium temperature requirements. The solar water heating is an example for the requirement, the non-concentrating solar thermal collectors which are used mainly for the solar water heating purpose. The concentrating collectors have a bigger interceptor than the absorber, while the non-concentrating collectors have both these interceptor and absorber of same sizes. You can see in this figure the temperature range on which these collectors operate. Concentrating solar collectors. Concentrating solar collectors use mirrors and lenses to reach higher temperature. It uses reflective surfaces to concentrate sunlight onto a small area where it is absorbed and converted to heat or solar photovoltaic devices into the electricity pump. There are two types of concentrating solar collector, imaging and non-imaging type. Imaging technologies, they make use of the mirrors and lenses, and imaging concentrators are called imaging because they produce an optical image of the sun on the receiver. These are further divided into two types based on the focus and receiver type. The line focus collectors track the sun along a single axis and focus the irradiance on a linear receiver. Point focus collector track the sun along two axes and focus the irradiance at a single point receiver, which allow for higher temperature. A receiver type, the fixed receivers are stationary devices that remain independent of the plant's focusing device, which eases the transport of collected heat. Mobile receivers move together with the focusing device, which enables more energy to be collected. These imaging technologies have a smaller range of acceptance angle compared to that of non-imaging technologies. Imaging concentration gives about one-third of the theoretical maximum for the design of acceptance angle. The non-imaging concentrators, they do not produce such an image of the sun, but rather disperse the light from the sun over the all area of the receiver. These concentrators have relatively low concentration ratio, normally it is less than 10, compared to that of imaging concentrators. Non-imaging optics have a larger acceptance angle range and can be used to approach the theoretical maximum. Now we will see in detail what are the common non-concentrating solar collectors. One type is the flat plate solar collector. It works on the principle that the radiation can be absorbed, reflected, transmitted if the incident radiation on a body is unity. The absorbed radiation increases the temperature of the body. It starts radiating heat to the surrounding as per the Boltzmann equation. Here, R is equal to epsilon sigma T to the power 4, where R is the OLR emitted by the earth. The Boltzmann equation is represented as R is equal to epsilon sigma to T to the power 4, where T is the OLR emitted by the earth. Sigma is the Stefan-Boltzmann constant, which is equal to 5.67 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 8 watt per meter square per Kelvin to the power minus 4, where epsilon is the emissivity of the earth. At equilibrium temperature, alpha Hg is equal to epsilon sigma T to the power 4, where Hg is intensity of the global radiation and alpha is the absorption coefficient. And this absorption coefficient can be increased by painting the black. What are the components of flat plate collector? Absorber plate that helps to intercept and absorb incident solar radiation. It is primarily a blackened heat absorbing plate, usually made up of copper, aluminium or steel. And it is also be given a coating to minimize the emission of heat from its surface. The second one is the transparent cover. It is made of one or more transparent sheet of glass or plastic and it is placed above the absorber plate. The cover allows radiation to reach the absorber plate, but it prevents any re-radiation and heat loss due to convection. The third component is the fluid tubes or the channels. These are arranged in thermal contact with the absorber plate so that heat can be transferred from the absorber plate to the fluid in the tubes or channels. Another component is the thermal insulation is provided under the absorber plate and the fluid tubes to minimize any heat loss by the transmission or convection from the absorber plate and fluid tubes. And there is a tight container or box. All the above components of the collector are protected by a tight container or the box. And this figure shows the layout of a flat plate solar collector and the fluid, the other side figure shows the fluid tube connection and the fluid flow in a flat plate solar collector. Now, what is the orientation of flat plate collector? The incident radiation should strike the absorbing surface at the right angle to reduce the losses by the reflection of the incident radiation from the absorbing surface. But the incident radiation changes its direction as per the movement of the sun in the sky. And the angle of incident of the sun also depend upon the altitude of the place, time of the day and time of the year. The collector should follow the sun in order to get maximum radiation. And the flat plate collectors are therefore kept facing south so that the maximum amount of energy can be extracted for all the places in the northern hemisphere. The collector is always kept inclined to horizontal position with optimum inclination facing the sun so that the maximum solar radiation is received throughout the day. The optimum inclination is kept as in summer the inclination is equal to latitude minus 15 degree, in winter inclination is equal to latitude plus 15 degree and round the year the inclination is equal to the latitude. The collector performance testing. If solar global radiation as measured by the pyranometer is Ig and collected area is AC, then the efficiency of the collector is given by the equation eta is equal to Q output divided by AC multiplied by Ig, or it can be represented as eta is equal to M, where Q output, if we substitute that Q output value, that is M multiplied by Cp multiplied by Tf2 minus Tf1 divided by AC multiplied by Ig. It will give the collector performance. Another type of non-concentrating solar collector is evacuated tube collector. In this system, heat loss is reduced by almost totally by eliminating the conduction and convection heat losses. The space between the absorber and the glass outer tube is evacuated. With little air to move and transfer heat by conduction and convection, heat loss is further reduced. Here, the radiation losses are also reduced by incorporating a selective surface on the absorber, which is similar to that flat plate collector. And as a result, evacuated tube collectors can operate at temperatures above 100 degrees Celsius compared with that of 100 degrees Celsius for the flat plate collectors. Here, instead of an absorber plate, water is pumped through absorber tubes, which are metal tubes with a selective solar radiation absorbing coating. that gaining heat before going into the collector pipe. Each absorber tube is housed inside a glass tube from which the air has been evacuated, forming a vacuum. The glass tube allows solar radiation through to the absorber tube where it can be turned into heat. And the vacuum eliminates convective as well as conductive heat loss, and virtually all heat absorbed is transferred to the water. And these evacuated tube collectors are more modern and more efficient in design. And it can heat water to much higher temperatures and require less area, but it is expensive. Now, the concentrating solar collector. The first one is the non-focus type solar, the concentrating solar collector, or you can say non-imaging concentrating solar collector. There are two types, modified flat plate and compound parabolic. The modified flat plate collector is a modified form of a flat plate collector, as it has plane reflectors at its edges to reflect additional radiation to the absorber or receiver, and so there is some concentration of solar radiation at the receiver. And the mirror reflectors are called booster mirrors, which increase the acceptance angle and concentration ratio of the flat plate reflectors from 1 to 4. You can see in this figure the modified flat plate collector's layout, or schematic representation of the modified flat plate collector. Compound parabolic concentrator is mainly a flat collector having two parabolic mirror reflectors attached at the edge of the flat plate collector. The parabolic mirror are so adjusted that the focus of one mirror is located at the bottom end of the mirror in contact with the receiver. The arrangement helps in increasing the acceptance angle. The concentration ratio achieved by this type of collector range from 3 to 4. And this figure represents the schematic diagram of the compound parabolic concentrator. And the concentrating solar collector focus type, or the imaging type. The line focus collector. First we will see the line focus collector with single axis tracking. The different types of line focus collector are cylindrical parabolic type, linear Fresnel lens collector, fixed mirror solar collector. Cylindrical parabolic concentrator consists of a cylindrical parabolic trough reflector with a metallic tube or receiver tube containing fluid at its focal line. The fluid tube is blackened at outer surface for the better absorption of solar radiation. The concentrated solar radiation reaching the fluid tube heats up the transport fluid flowing through it. This collector is oriented to any of the three directions, east-west, north-south, or the polar. Hence, such collectors need one-axis tracking system, which can move the collector as per the sun's movement in the sky. These types of collectors have the concentration ratio in the range of 5 to 30. Another type is the linear Fresnel lens collector. Here, the concentrated in the form of Fresnel lens is used. This Fresnel lens consists of fine and linear grooves which are formed on one of the surfaces of some refracting material sheet, while its other surface is flat. The grooves provided on the sheet are designed in such a manner that these behave similar to that of spherical lens to every incident light rays. The incident radiation therefore converges to a focal line of the lens system where the fluid tube is provided. We can see this in this figure. The heat is transferred to the transport fluid flowing into the fluid tube. Here the concentration ratio range from 10 to 30. And the temperature range of such collector varies from 150 to 300 degrees Celsius. Fixed mirror solar concentrator. This concentrator consists of a number of long narrow mirror strips fixed on the circumference of a certain reference cylinder with a tracking receiver or fluid tube moving at the same circular circumference. The mirrors are arranged in such a manner that the incident radiation on them is focused on the receiver tube or their common focal circle. The receiver tube is made to move along the focal circle by a tracking device as per the movement of sun in the sky. The concentration ratio of the concentrator is equal to the number of mirrors which are used for the concentration of radiation. The next type is the focus type concentrating solar collector or imaging type collector. Point focus collector with a dual axis tracking. The paraboloidal dish collector, hemispherical bowl mirror concentrator, circular Fresnel lens concentrator, central tower receiver collector are the types of this. Paraboloidal dish collector. Point focus collector has a dish of the shape of a paraboloid. That is, surface produced when a parabola is rotated about its axis. The paraboloidal surface can concentrate all the incident radiation parallel to its axis to a movement to a point focus where the receiver tube is positioned. In order to ensure proper incidence of radiation, the parabolic dish collector should be provided with two axis tracking, either by rotating the support structure about the vertical axis for the dish alignment, or the dish is rotated about a horizontal axis for the elevation tracking. Here the concentration ratio range from 10 to 1000 that helps to produce a temperature up to 3000 degrees Celsius. You can see in these figures, the one is the generation of paraboloid surface and the other is the parabolic surface concentrating radiation. The next type is the circular Fresnel lens concentrator. It is similar to linear Fresnel collector but designed to concentrate the radiation at one focal point instead of line focus. These Fresnel lenses concentrator are used when high concentration of radiation is required. The concentrator has a number of thin circular zones with fine grooves so designed that the lens concentrator behaves optically as a thin spherical lens. The sun rays are made to refract and converge at a point. The concentration ratio obtained by this concentrator is about 2000. The next is the central tower receiver collector. The receiver is located at the top of a tower and solar radiation is reflected on it from a large number of independently controlled flat mirror, which is called heliostat. The heliostats can be moved independently about two axes so that the reflected solar radiation is always directed towards the absorber mounted on the tower. The heliostats are spread over a large area on ground surrounding the absorber mounted on the tower. A number of heliostats can be as high as thousands and they simultaneously track the sun to reflect the solar radiation from all the sides of a receiver on the receiver. These heliostats together act as a very large paraboloidal dish collector. The concentration ratio of 3000 can be obtained by this point type of collector and this is called central tower receiver collector. The solar radiation at the receiver is converted into heat, which is transported to a heat engine or any other device for use. Let's compare the flat and focusing collector or the concentrated and non-concentrated collector. The flat collectors, the absorber area is large. The concentration ratio is 1 or low, you can say. The temperature range is low and it is not more than 70 degrees Celsius. So limited to low temperature uses. And it can use both beam and diffuse radiation. And it is simple in construction and maintenance and there is no tracking system. And these flat collectors are less costly and suitable for all the places as it can work in clear and cloudy days. While the focusing collectors, here the absorber area is small, the concentration ratio is high, 4 to 3000. The temperature range is also high, up to 3000 degrees Celsius. So high temperature applications such as power generation, for power generation we can use focusing type collector. It uses mainly the beam radiation. It has more complicated design and difficult in the maintenance and it requires tracking system and it is costly compared to flat collector. It is suitable. Focusing collectors are suitable where more clear and sunny days prevail. It's not suitable for the all places. We have seen different types of solar collector. Now we will see the concentrating solar thermal technology which are using mainly the concentrated solar collector. This concentrated solar technologies, or abbreviated as CSTs, track the sun's incoming radiation with mirror fields which concentrate the energy towards the absorbers which then transfer it thermally to the working medium. The heated fluid or the stem reach high temperatures and can be used for various industrial and commercial heat applications. Industries such as food processing, dairy, paper and pulp, chemicals, textiles, fertilizers, breweries, electroplating, pharmaceutical, rubber, desalination and tobacco sectors are making use of this technology. The most mature concentrated solar technologies are the point focus technology. The most mature concentrated solar technologies are point focus technology, line focus technology and non-focus technology. The point focus technology, the most common or the most matured technologies under this are fixed focus automatically tracked elliptical dish, and successful commercially operated this type of technology is Scheffler dish. Fresnel reflected based dish, Arun dish is an example. And the third one is a dual axis tracked paraboloid dish. All these three comes under the point focus technology. In the line focus technology, the parabolic truck collectors, that is PTC, and linear Fresnel reflected type, that is LFR, are the major ones. And in under the non-focusing technology, the compound parabolic collector is the main one. Now the fixed focus elliptical dish, Scheffler dish concentrator. It's a small lateral section of a paraboloid which concentrates sun's radiation over a fixed focus. The dish comprises of a large number of mirrors to reflect the sun's rays to a fixed receiver which contains a working fluid to be heated. And you can see the schematic representation of this in this figure. And the principle of Scheffler dish system. Here, the parabolic reflective dish turns about north-south axis parallel to Earth's axis, which track the sun's movement from the morning, that is the east, to evening, to the west. The parabolic reflector also performs change in inclination angle while staying directed to sun in order to obtain sharp focal point. And the focus always lies at the axis of rotation. And it remains at a fixed position where concentrated heat is captured and transferred to water through the receiver to generate hot water or high pressure steam. The water from header pipe passes to the receiver in a thermosiphon principle is followed in it. At the end of the receiver, the hot water or steam generated water are collected in the header pipe which flows to the end use application. The advantages of this type of collector are, these are useful for the community cooking, air conditioning and other applications. As a stationary receiver, it is mounted on the ground and the system is structurally simple and has no rotating or flexible joints for water and steam. And it can be installed on rooftops of existing buildings. But the disadvantages are larger floor, ground area is required for the installation compared to other CST technologies based because the dish and the receiver must be mounted separately. So it requires more space. The Scheffler dishes deliver heat from late in the morning till early evening and are therefore suitable only for operations which use heat during this period. Fresnel reflected based dish, Arun dish, is one of the most commercial type and it is made from panels of flat mirrors which are mounted on a frame such that the incident sunlight is reflected onto a cavity receiver which is specially designed to reduce heat losses. The receiver, which is insulated on the outside, is held in a fixed position in relation to the reflectors by means of a suitable structure. The entire array of panels with the receiver move to track the sun. And the cavity receivers allow the energy to be intercepted by a small aperture or opening which results in low losses. Usually these Fresnel dish are large and it has an aperture area of 100 meter square to 160 meter square. And the reflector and the receiver mounted on top are moved to track the sun such that the reflector faces the sun at all the times throughout the year. And the systems, because of their size, require careful structural design to withstand heavy weight and strong winds. Paraboloid dish, it consists of mirrors mounted on a truss structure such that the incident sunlight is reflected onto a cavity receiver which is specially designed to reduce convective and radiation heat losses. The receiver, which is insulated on the outside, is held in a fixed position in relation to the reflector by means of a suitable structure. And the entire array of mirrors and receiver move to track the sun. The cavity receivers allow energy to be intercepted by a small aperture or opening which results in low losses. The reflector and receiver mounted on top are moved to track the sun such that reflector faces the sun at all the times throughout the year. These systems have light structures and these paraboloid dishes can be installed on rooftops of the existing building, though this may require some strengthening of the structure and it must be designed by the experts. They can be mounted wherever the space permits and it is suitable for the retrofitting in the congested layouts. And the paraboloid dishes are pole mounted and thus have a small footprint. And it has high concentration ratio and relatively low losses from the receiver. It allows its operating temperature to be as high as 350 degrees Celsius. And the use of thermic fluids allows high temperature operation at low pressures. Parabolic trough concentrator. These are troughs made from shaped metal and coated with a reflecting material such as highly polished metal, normally aluminium is used, or metallized plastic, which can withstand sunlight as well as rain and other elements. These surfaces reflect the incident sunlight onto a metallic collector pipe, that is a receiver, that runs axially along the trough. The pipe is specially coated to increase its absorption of the sunlight that falls on it and is encased in a glass tube to reduce convective heat losses from the receiver. Several such PTCs can be connected in series on a common axis. And two common methods of mounting PTCs are with the focal axis in a horizontal east-west direction, and the trough is adjusted continuously so that the incident sunlight has the least angle of incidence. In the horizontal north-south direction, with the troughs being moved to track the sun from east to west from morning to evening. These systems are preferable when large contiguous area is available and relatively large quantities of heat are needed. The PTC have the highest insulation globally for power generation, and also it enjoys the successful market share for the process heat application. Since the troughs are long, they have to be structurally strong enough to withstand distortions. Otherwise, the efficiency suffers. The PTCs have the rotating or flexible joints for the water and steam, and these have to be maintained well to prevent the leakages. These PTCs, paraboloidal trough concentrator, can be installed on the rooftops of the existing building after establishing the structural load limits. It has a medium concentration ratio and relatively high losses from the receiver. If the annulus between the receiver and its protection tube is not evacuated, then the losses will be high. And its operating temperature limit is up to 250 degrees Celsius. The efficiency of PTCs drops rapidly with an increase in the operating temperature. It requires a large floor or ground area for installation as compared to other CST technologies because of their configuration. The Nuclear Power Corporation of India Limited. Nuclear Power Corporation of India Limited installed a 641 square meter, 100 numbers of 6.41 square meter system by the Thermax in Rajasthan for the cooling purpose. The National Institute of Solar Energy, NISE, installed a 308 square meter system by the Thermax in Gurgaon, Haryana for cooling purpose of this type collector. Linear Fresnel reflector. Linear Fresnel reflecting concentrator is made from multiple strips of straight reflecting material, which are mounted on specially designed frames. The mirrors are arranged in a Fresnelized manner, which reflects the incident sunlight onto a focal line of metallic collector pipe that runs axially above the array of reflectors. The pipe may be specially coated to increase their absorption of the sunlight that falls on them and is encased in a glass tube to reduce convective heat losses from the receiver. Sometimes to improve this insulation effect, the space between the receiver and the glass envelope is evacuated and the ends are sealed. The upper portion of the receiver is often insulated to prevent heat loss. The reflector strips are moved such that they always reflect the incident sunlight onto the receiver tube. Several such linear Fresnel reflecting concentrators are connected in series on a common axis. And two common methods of mounting this linear Fresnel reflecting concentrators are with the focal axis are in the horizontal east-west direction, and the reflectors are adjusted continuously so that the incident sunlight has the least angle of incidence. In the horizontal north-south direction, with the troughs being moved to track the sun from east to west from morning to evening. These systems are preferred when large area is available and large quantities of heat are needed. They have the efficiency similar to that of PTCs, but it can be made more robust. The linear Fresnel reflector collector is a single axis tracking technology, but it enjoys the modularity and has a working installation for the desalination of seawater and for the power generation. Since the reflectors are long and they have to be structurally strong or well supported to withstand the distortion, otherwise their efficiency suffers. These LFRCs do not have a rotating or flexible joints for the water or steam, and therefore leakages do not occur. And it has a medium concentration ratio and relatively high losses from the receiver if that annulus between the receiver and its protection tube is not evacuated. And it also has the operating temperature limit up to 250 degrees Celsius. A large floor or the ground area is required for the installation of this type of collector as compared to other technologies. And some of the installations of this type of collector in India are solar thermal power plant at the National Institute of Solar Energy, A 1 MW solar thermal power plant is installed in this one in collaboration with IIT Mumbai. Then seawater desalination plant, Ramanathapuram, Tamil Nadu, also has this type of solar collector. The next type is the non-imaging concentrator. To make an image, all the parallel light rays should be concentrated at a single point. The non-imaging collectors are the collectors which can't make the image of the sun. These non-imaging concentrators are also known as compound parabolic collectors. This non-imaging concentrator consists of a specially coated absorber tube that is enclosed in a concentric glass cover to reduce the convection losses. And the annulus between the tube and its cover is evacuated. And the tube is placed at the focal plane of two reflectors which are shaped as parabolic troughs. The axis of the two parabolas are inclined at the acceptance angle, which is the angle by which direct light may deviate from the normal and yet allow the reflected light to reach the receiver. A high acceptance angle requires fewer tracking adjustments. Usually, such concentrators are made of panels which are 1 to 6 meter wide and can go up to 60 meter of collector area. The receiver carries the fluid to be heated, which could be water or thermic fluid, and are connected to each receiver tube by means of a header. The most common method of this panel mounting of this non-imaging concentrator is in the east-west direction, with a panel facing south and inclined from the ground at an angle of latitude plus 10 degree. The concentrated solar power technology. Till now we have seen the concentrated solar thermal technology. Now the concentrated solar power technology. It works on the principle, it is also a solar thermal technology. Here, the light energy of the sun is concentrated by using reflective mirrors to generate heat, which in turn produces steam to run a turbine. The generator coupled with the turbine rotates and produces electricity. And these technologies include a parabolic trough collector, linear Fresnel reflector, heliostat field collectors, and dish Stirling engines. The heliostat field collectors. It's power tower or central receiver plant. These are named helio for sun and stat for the fact that the reflected solar image is maintained at a stationary position throughout the day. They are nearly flat mirrors that collect and concentrate the solar energy on a tower mounted receiver which is located 100 to 1000 meters distant. And these heliostats track the sun throughout the day to maintain the sun's image on the solar receiver. It has the advantages like the solar energy is collected optically and transferred to a single receiver point, thus minimizing thermal energy transport requirements. They typically achieve concentration ratios of 100 to 1500 and so are highly efficient both in collecting energy and in converting it to electricity. It can be conveniently stored as thermal energy. They are quite large, normally more than 10 megawatt, and thus benefit from economies of scale. You can see in this slide the comparison of various solar collectors which are fixed as well as the mobile receivers. You can see in this table the technology which we have already discussed, the common technologies which are used in India, and its tracking, focus type, operating temperature range and efficiency. And out of these solar collectors, you can see the paraboloid dish and the Arund dish has higher efficiency compared to the other solar collectors. And its working operating temperature is also high, 150 to 400 degree Celsius. You can see in this slide the pictures of Fresnel dishes as well as the design variant of Arund dishes which are commonly used for cooking and process heating and cooling in India, and you can see the various installations at the Sangli, Pune, ITC Maurya Delhi, Akshardham Delhi. These are the Fresnel dishes, dish type solar collector. And you can see the different variants of Arund 160, 130. You can see the shape, the structure, the variation in this structure. Optical efficiency. It describes the system's ability to absorb radiation that strikes normal to the concentrated aperture. When the direct solar radiation reaches the surface of solar collectors, a significant amount of it is lost due to several different factors. The total loss can be divided into three types. One is the optical losses. The solar radiation incident upon this collector that is not converted to heat energy due to different factors like reflectivity of the collector that reflects from the surface, transmissivity of the glass tube, intercept factor, that is losses due to tracking geometry heat removal factor of the fluid, and the absorptivity of the absorber selective coating. The next is the thermal heat losses. The solar radiation that is converted to heat but lost before it can be used. These losses are due to three modes of heat transfer within the collector: the radiative heat transfer loss, convective heat transfer loss, and the conductive heat transfer loss. And the third type of loss is the geometrical losses due to the incidence angle of direct solar radiation on the aperture plane of the collector. And the incidence angle of the direct solar radiation is very important factor, because the fraction of direct radiation that is useful to the collector is directly proportional to the cosine of this angle, which also reduces useful aperture area of solar collector. Applications of solar collectors. The industrial process heating. The heat produced from the solar energy can be used for various applications in different sectors, like process heating, drying, distillation or desalination, water heating, space heating and refrigeration, and the power electricity generation. The power generation on a large scale, community cooking and space cooling or space heating. From the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy, until the August 2015, the cumulative installed capacity of solar water heaters in India was close to 10 million square meter. And the Thar Desert in Rajasthan receives more than 2000 kilowatt hour of direct normal irradiance per square meter per annum. It is estimated to be sufficient to generate 700 to 2100 gigawatts of energy. In this table, you can see the different industrial process with applications with the temperature. Out of the 470 megawatt allotted to the concentrated solar power plants in the Jawaharlal Nehru National Solar Mission Phase 1, only 200 megawatt is operational. And the target assigned for the Phase 2 of this JNSSM, the target assigned for Phase 2 of the Jawaharlal Nehru National Solar Mission for solar collector is 15 million square meter. This is not limited to the water heater, but it also includes all the collectors, since the potential for the water heater is only 9.52. But there is no available data for the achievement of this target is available. What are the challenges in this technology? Since the concentrators can focus only direct solar radiation, their performance is poor on cloudy days. The tracking mechanisms must be used to move the collector during the day to keep them focused on the sun. The maintenance and construction cost of the system are therefore considerably increased. The concentrators are only practical in areas of high direct insulation, such as arid and desert areas. And there is no local manufacturing is available. And the lack of local manufacturing facilities for some critical components. Depending on the imports also cause delays for the delays in these type of projects. There is no skilled manpower. Many of the components require, it could be produced locally. Many of the components which are required could be produced locally. But without prior experience and lack of in-house skills, this was a challenge which hindered this technology. So to summarize, we have seen what is a solar collector, what is its importance in solar thermal technology. We have seen different types of solar collector: low temperature, medium temperature and high temperature collectors based on the requirement. And we have also seen the concentrated and non-concentrated type of solar collectors and how they differ from each other. We have seen different types of these, the subdivisions of these solar collectors. And we have seen the optical efficiency of solar collector with different what chances of losses it can occur in the solar collector. And we have also seen the different solar thermal technologies as well as the solar power technologies, and which are mostly undergoing in India, and also the installations of the solar collectors in various parts of India. Thank you.